Hi, Haunted Family. Welcome back. I think I've got a really good episode for you today. So sit back, enjoy the show, and if you like what you hear, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. Story 1. Haunted Hospital Room. I wasn't even really sure I believed in ghosts until recently. I live in New York City, and about a year ago, a friend of mine had a mild heart condition. One day, after a lot of stress in his business, he had a massive stress attack. Because of his condition, he ended up in the hospital. I decided to visit him one morning before work. I went to his room and noticed the bathroom door slightly ajar. I heard shuffling sounds and water running, so I assumed that someone was in there. I saw the bed from the doorway and naturally assumed that since the bed was empty, my friend was in the bathroom. Being female, and my friend being male, I just automatically told him that I was in the room and not to come out indecent. Something was mumbled back, but I didn't understand it. I sat down and waited. His roommate was soundly sleeping, snoring away. I still heard sounds in the bathroom. The door opened. I distinctly heard slippers shuffling out of the room, but the sounds were unaccompanied by a body. I got up fast and went out to the nurse's station to ask where my friend was. They told me that he had been out for a procedure, and it wasn't done yet. Well, needless to say, I didn't stick around and wait for him. I visited him after he was out of the hospital and asked if he had noticed anything unusual in his room. He said he was on too many painkillers to notice anything. I've never felt the same in that hospital since. Story 2. Vacation Ghost. Okay, y'all, I'm a real skeptic here. And about 10 years ago, I was in Acapulco, Mexico, vacationing alone. In my hotel room one night, I woke and was startled by a face of a Mexican Indian intruder hovering over me. His face was inches from mine. I swung at him, but there was no body. The face rose back and upwards away from me, and then just disappeared. I turned on the light and reflected on what had just happened. And then I brushed it off and had a wonderful vacation. About a year later, almost to the date, I was in my apartment, in my room, sleeping rather soundly, when I awoke to find a grayish figure levitating directly above my head. I panicked, and it slowly dissolved before my eyes. Thereafter, the appearances have been different every time, but usually consisting of a head, shoulder, and torso. The same pattern. I awake suddenly from my sleep, and the figure is there, almost as if studying me. It always takes about 10 minutes to disappear or walk away. The figures have been at the foot of my bed. They have been above me. They have even walked across the room away from me. I've never seen the faces. At times, they are just shadowy. I'm now living in another apartment, and the apparitions still visit me. Could there be a logical explanation? The figures may be carried over from my sleep? It's scary because I always think that there's an intruder in my room when I see them. A good friend of mine, like a brother, spent the night the other night. He shared the bed with me and my dog. I awoke and saw the apparition again, while he was fast asleep. I was slightly startled, but made no commotion. It disappeared, and I went back to sleep. I never discussed this with him, although a few years ago, I told him about other sightings. He's an even bigger skeptic than me. The next day, while driving his car, he turned to me, out of the blue, and asked, "Do you still see those ghosts at night?" I asked him if I had awakened him when I saw it last night. He was surprised, having had no idea that it appeared to me. He told me that he had had a vivid dream and a very, very real nightmare. In his dream, we were in bed, in the same positions, the dog in the middle. I woke him and pointed to the bottom of the bed, where he saw a figure with a hideous smile. It was the devil. I begged my friend to make it go away. I told him that he visits and scares me all the time. I handed my friend a wand, and he swung it to no avail. The devil remained defiant and grinning. My friend made a cross with his fingers and started to pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, and the figure vanished. After discussing this in the car, we were both astonished. How can this be? Why both in the same night? My friend told me that he has never had a more realistic dream in his life, and he never feels afraid in his apartment, but his skepticism is wearing thin. Story 3. Vacant Room. I used to work in a 6-bed PICU and was there late one night with another nurse and a CNA. The room on the very end was unoccupied, and we were having a fairly quiet shift. As we sat at the nurse's station, we heard this beeping sound twice in a row. We knew this sound, but couldn't recall from where. It happened every few minutes as we hunted for it and kept telling each other that it was a sound we heard daily. But from what? Then we followed it down the unit into the vacant room. The sound was the double beep our beds made in the mornings when we weigh our patients. Spooky thing was, there was no patient in that bed. Okay, so it's malfunctioning, right? Nope. The bed was unplugged from the wall, and the plug lay on top of the mattress. So the battery was low. Except, these beds don't have a battery backup to them. When they're unplugged, nothing works on them. Nothing. That, along with the crying baby we heard from that room occasionally, really freaked us night shifters out. Story 4. Kentucky. My story will seem strange to most, but it's absolutely true. I recently moved in with a longtime friend of mine. There have been some strange things happening in his house for many years. His family had built the house and has lived there for around 35 years. 3 out of the 4 children in the family claim to have seen apparitions or felt something unusual in the house. All 3 of them actually saw things when they were really young. As they got older, they usually only felt the presence. When I moved in, I noticed strange things happening. I'd always felt that there was something special about that house, but not scary. On several occasions, I would think I heard my friend yelling for me. Then, I would go to where he was, and he would not have said a word. One night, I thought I heard my son calling for me. I went to his bedroom to check, and I found him sound asleep. I have also been standing in the kitchen and felt like someone had walked up behind me. I would start talking to them because I would think that it was somebody in the family. And then, when I turned around, I would find no one there. When I first moved in, I was asleep downstairs in the bedroom, and I was having a very strange, very detailed dream. I was dreaming about a woman telling me she was going to knock over the gun rack. She was going to knock it off the wall. She was very insistent and very rude. I had never seen anyone like this before in my life. In my dream, I was arguing with her, but she kept insisting. That night, I woke up to a loud crash. It scared me, but I was too sleepy to go check on it. The next morning, the gun rack was on the floor. I couldn't understand how it could have fallen. It had been there for years. When we looked closer, the nail had actually been bent. We couldn't pin another explanation on it. This was only one of many things I have experienced. A couple years previous to this, my friend's sister had an experience. She pulled up the driveway that night, and she thought she saw her niece running down the stairs that led to the basement. She pulled on up the driveway, but she didn't see her brother's vehicle anywhere. She jumped out of the car and ran to the stairwell and saw nothing. She said she got chills. She said the apparition looked like a young girl, maybe 10 years old, with blonde hair. She had a coat on, and that's all she could remember. The strange thing about this, there have not been many occurrences of actually seeing a ghost. About a year back, we all sat down and talked about our experiences. We all agreed that whatever there is here isn't bad. We each talked about how we felt safe in the house, like something was here to protect us. Everyone had a very sentimental attachment to a certain tree in the yard. Every one of them has had a paranormal experience around this tree. I would like to research who owned the property before my friend's family bought it. I was told there was a house somewhere on the property where the woods are now, but I haven't had the time to actually research yet or to search the woods for the house seat. Everyone seems to think that the presence is a child. I believe that it either changes form or there's more than one spirit. My friend told me a story about playing hide-and-seek with a group of neighbor children when they were little. He was trying to find his brother when he thought he had spotted him under the big tree. He ran over to tag him, and it was a little boy lying on his belly with his head on his hands. The boy smiled at him, and he said he realized that it wasn't his brother or any of the other children, and he ran away. He says it was a young Native American boy. In the area where his property is located, many Native artifacts have been found. I don't doubt that at least one of the spirits is of a Native boy. It's really hard to explain the feeling you get when you go into their house. After living here for several months, I'm beginning to feel it more and more. I'm not afraid to stay here by myself. It feels safe. But not just in the house. Every one of us have felt the same feeling in the woods, by the tree, and just sitting out on the back porch. It seems to be occupying the entire property. I know this sounds very strange, but it's all very true. I hope in the future to find out more about the property's history in hopes of determining why the spirit is here.